RedShipStrikeSevenSports.com. In today's video, I just want to talk about, the upcoming 2023-2024 season for the Memphis Tigers men's basketball program. More in particular on their chances of getting to this year's Final Four event, which will be played in Phoenix, Arizona. Last year was in Houston. This year will be in Phoenix. And I just want to talk about, in regards to the Final Four, the chance of getting to the Final Four, and pose the question of if it's a realistic possibility. And just based on what they have done in the offseason, the moves that they made, the way Penny Hardaway has constructed the roster. I would say, it's not me being trying to sound like a homer or anything like that. But I think that's a chance, bro. That's a significant chance, a real possibility that this team gets to the NCAA tournament, but gets to the Final Four. I think that's a chance, man. If teams like FAU, who will be playing in the American this season, can get to the tournament, I'm pretty sure Memphis can. That was a veteran team, with talent, guys that were hungry, guys like that. They got to the tournament. I'm pretty sure Memphis could do the same thing. You got one of the most experienced teams in the league, this season, in college basketball. The older team, and it's not like you don't have a team full of five-star recruits, former four-star recruits on it. It's not like you got guys that, they're not from the transfer portal, but you recruited them, but they weren't like well-known talents coming out of out of high school. You got guys that have played in big games before. Guys that have been recognized as 4 and 5 star recruits, at, I would say, perennial powerhouses right now in the country in college basketball. Even though Alabama is not the traditional blue blood in college basketball, right now they are one of the marquee names in the program. That's how you got a guy like Javon Quinterly. John Brown is a former player of the year for the mid-majors of college basketball. He's a former player of the year for the mid-majors and mid-major programs in college basketball last season. Guys like Jaquan Walton, David Jones. Kentucky was after David Jones. You know what I'm saying? Nicholas Jourdain. You got guys that can get you, I believe, that can hold it down and get you to the tournament, get you deep in the tournament. Without question, I know this team is going to the tournament this year for the third straight year under Penny Hardaway. Without question. But when it wants to get in the tournament, can they go far? I think so. And I know last year a lot of people started to recognize Memphis towards the end of the season. And when this tournament, when it starts to like build up for the actual tournament kicking off, people start recognizing Memphis as a Final Four team, a dark horse team that could get to the Final Four. That could be the same type of meeting this year. You know what I'm saying? You got the players that can hold it down. You got the players that can catch fire during the tournament that can hold it down for you and you know what I'm saying, and go on a run, like similar to how FAU did, similar to how the Connecticut Huskies did. Guys that can score points and get on a hot streak, you know, that 2 to 3 game stretch during the NCAA tournament and get you to the big dance down in Phoenix. You know what I'm saying? I believe you have that, you know. And it'd be really interesting to see what the younger guys can do as well. You know what I'm saying? The younger guys on the roster, guys like Karl Shanahan, Ashton Hardaway, JJ Taylor, what those guys can do and doing that with this type of team. You know what I'm saying? So, like I said, without question, I understand. I think this team can get to the tournament, could get deep in the tournament and get to the NCAA, to the men's Final Four this season. You know, it depends. Like these games, you know, the out of conference game, out of conference schedule, out of conference game schedule, pre-game schedule, it's not that bad, bro. It's deep. I think it's pretty solid. You know, you're playing powerhouses like Virginia, a Texas A&M team that's ranked higher this year at 15. Ole Miss got the other new head coach that was at Texas before he got fired. Missouri's supposed to be a pretty good squad this year. Vanderbilt, they say Vanderbilt is supposed to be good. And on to the conference play, you know, I just think this is gonna be real, you know, interesting to see how it's gonna play out. I think it's just setting up perfectly for the Tigers to go on a deep run. Perfectly. You know. And like I said before, people say that FAU is the threat to Memphis. I still think it's like Tulane, bro. Because Tulane give Memphis. I know Memphis got them back in the AAC tournament last season, but the regular season, Tulane beat Memphis twice, swept them, give them issues in bowl games. Second game, Memphis took them to overtime, but Tulane got it done though, got the win. You know, so we'll see, man. But other than that, man, it's just once you get out of this conference play, you get done with out of conference play, get into your regular schedule, your regular your conference, your in conference schedule, it should be smooth sailings, bro. You know, but like I said, biggest challenge for Hardaway gonna be keeping his team focused and not allowing them to like lose track, lose focus. You know what I'm saying? Don't get caught up in, you know, the know your stats and all that, and you know, positioning yourself for the NBA and all that, things like that. Not saying nothing's wrong with that, but it could come up time where it could you know, cloud what you're doing, what you're trying to accomplish at the collegiate level. You know what I'm saying? So I think it's gonna be I think there's gonna be a chance for this team to do something special this year, you know. All right, so the latest story that came out for college basketball this season from ESPN under you know, the writer Myron Metcalf, they put a key storylines for all 32 D1 conferences ahead of the 2020 season. And for the American, he was talking about how does the conference for the new teams in the conference to help stabilize the league. I'm just gonna go ahead and read what stated on the write-up for the American. This is a different league this season. Although the conference lost Houston, Cincinnati, and UF, we're all in the Big 12 right now. The rivals of Florida Atlantic, one of 2023 Final Four teams and capable of winning the AAC title in its first season. North Texas, UAB, Charlotte, and Rice, UTSA seen the league through the chaos of realignment. With its ability to maintain a streak of earning multiple bids on Selection Sunday, 9 consecutive seasons could become more difficult. There's also fear surrounding the program that could be a target for other leagues as realignment continues. I mean, in regards to the realignment stuff for Memphis, man, I just think that's going to happen another 2 years from now. I think in another 2 years possibly happen. I won't get my hopes up on it, but I think in 2 years Memphis could be in another conference. Yeah, that's gonna be important, man. These teams, I don't think these teams that these new teams are gonna be any good this year outside of FAU and maybe UAB, Charlotte and Rice, North Texas. UTSA will not be a good will not have good teams this year. But because they have to be really good. This conference needs to be strong enough to where you can get multiple bids. I think right now the most bids this conference can get is like two, if I'm not mistaken. The conference winner and the multiple the automatic bid. But other than that, man, that's it. American, regardless of his storyline for the upcoming season. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and just segue to the AP poll, the Associated Press top 25 preseason poll that came out, I believe, Monday, October 16th. And KU is the number one team. Kansas is the number one team, followed by Duke, Purdue, Michigan State, Marquette, UConn, Houston, Creighton, Tennessee, FAU. They like FAU that much that they put them at 10. They ranked them at number 10. Number 10, bro. That's high, man. Gonzaga, Arizona, Miami, Arkansas, Texas A&M, Kentucky, San Diego State, who was in the Final Four last year, they got 17 ranking. Texas at 18, North Carolina at 19, Baylor at 20, USC 21, 22 Villanova, 23. You got St. Mary's, 24 Alabama, 25 Illinois. So with that being said, man. If Memphis does get to the tournament, well, I know they get into the tournament, but if they get in the Final Four, to the Final Four, chances are high they can be playing against one of these programs, bro, within the top 10. Playing against somebody like Kansas, Duke, Purdue, Michigan State, any one of these teams, UConn. Though it depends on how it's set up. You know what I'm saying? But the chances are high. I think the chances are high for this program to get to the Final Four this season, man. I really do. You know what I'm saying? It's not out of the realm of possibility. It's just not because what we saw last year and year prior to last year is that once March Madness comes around, anybody can get it, man. Anybody can get caught. Any top 10 team, any blue blood program to get got on any particular day. It don't matter, bro. You ain't coming into that game locked in, ready to go. You could take an L. You know what I'm saying? And even the blue blood programs at the top are having issues with keeping these teams, locked in, keeping them focused. Especially what you got when you got the NIL now and the transfer portal. You got that factor in play now. A mid-major can go out if they got, money behind them and big time donors backing them. They could go out and just buy a team and get it, put a team together, give them some NIL money and could compete for a championship. Compete for a conference championship. You know what I'm saying? Get to the tournament. That's how competitive it has gotten in college basketball. You know what I'm saying? But I think Memphis is going to be fine, man. I think the sky's the limit, man. I'm not saying hyperbole or anything like that. I just believe that this team, this roster is deep enough to challenge for. That could challenge a team like, shoot, Kentucky, Tennessee, Alabama. I know that was a close game with Alabama last year, but go against, challenge Alabama, Miami, Duke, Kansas. I believe that. You know what I'm saying? So we just gotta wait and see, man. We got, I believe it's October 21st today. We're 2 weeks away from the tip-off against Jackson State Monday at FedEx Forum. And after that, man, you're going to roll for first challenge of the season, toughest challenge of the season against Missouri. Penny Hardaway will be out those first three games and come back and do the battle for Atlanta in Michigan, in the Bahamas to play Michigan. So we'll see. All right, so that's for y'all for right now, man. Give me a like, comment, subscribe to the channel. Let me know how you feel. Do you believe there's a realistic chance that Memphis can get to the Final Four this season? Also, check out strikezonesports.com for its content on the Memphis Tigers football and basketball program. Have a blessed day. Peace. I'm out.